It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Oh, geez, that's great. Is the lighting halfway decent?
Yes, indeed. They've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the lunar surface.
The last thing before we go tonight, return to the moon. Back on July 20th, 1969, Neil Armstrong became the first man to ever walk on the lunar surface. Some 53 years later, we are still waiting on the first woman to take those momentous steps. But we may be getting closer, and the start of the nation's long-awaited next trip to the moon could be just a few days away. On Monday, NASA is hoping to kick off its first moon mission in 50 years, the launch of an uncrewed test spacecraft called Artemis I, as Lester Holt explains.
Sitting on launch pad 39B, the Artemis rocket, NASA's most powerful yet, taller than the Statue of Liberty. 55 engines and motors will lift the nearly 600 million pound rocket skyward on a historic mission, a first step to eventually return Americans to the lunar surface.
So how real is this, going back to the moon?
Oh, it's very real. We're definitely going. We're going to actually live there. We will have landers go to the moon. We'll have rovers on the moon. And eventually, we'll have a base camp on the moon.
Once beyond the pole of Earth's gravity, the Orion capsule perched atop of the rocket will orbit the moon for 42 days, uncrewed, but with male and female astronaut dummies loaded with sensors to study the potential effects of the mission on future real astronauts. Jessica Meir is one of 18 veteran astronauts, part of the Artemis team, who could fly on the first mission to the moon since 1972. The goal, learn more about the moon and use it as a jumping off point to Mars.
Learn more about the moon. Artemis 1 is scheduled for liftoff from NASA's Kennedy Space Center between 8:33 a.m. and 10:33 a.m. Eastern on Monday morning. We will be watching. We hope you will, too.